Medical Watch, have you thought about what's in the water we use every day to drink, cook, and clean with?
As Dina Bear reports, local researchers are working on a quick test method that may even be used to test for COVID-19.
What's in the water? Imagine if you could test for yourself. It's simple and it's rapid, and it all hinges on harnessing the power of another natural resource, bacteria. Local researchers are working on an at-home kit.
Well before COVID-19 reached our shores, researchers at Northwestern University were deep in the process of studying water, particularly how to detect what may be lurking in it.
One of the biggest issues with water quality for humans is that we can't often taste or see these contaminants that are in there. So, you know, you got a perfectly clear bottle of water right there, it could have toxic levels of lead in it.
There are existing laboratory methods to detect a variety of contaminants like lead, copper, fluoride, and antibiotics, to name a few.
One of the coolest things about natural organisms is that they are constantly monitoring their environment. It's trying to figure out if things are there. Some of the same things that are toxic to us are toxic to them. We don't have to invent a new giant instrument or machine to detect these things. We can leverage what nature has already evolved to do this.
Like Staphylococcus aureus, or Staph, a common bacteria in our environment that happens to have a natural mechanism in its infrastructure that works like actual taste buds to detect lead.
What we've learned a lot about is how those little molecular taste buds work in nature and figure out how to take them out of the cell and put them in a test tube so that when you put your water sample in there, they kind of activate and trigger these processes.
First, Dr. Julius Lux and his team extract the taste buds from the microbe and replicate the structures in the lab. Then they add the synthetic material to a water sample. The taste buds have been reprogrammed to light up if they detect a contaminant.
This is what the test actually looks like. So a person would kind of open up the strip of tubes, put a drop of water in, and then, you know, kind of give it a little flick, wait a little while, and then you would want to see if it lit up. So inside each one of these tubes would be a different molecular taste bud. You know, one might be for lead, one might be for copper, a few of these might be for different antibiotics or something like that.
We gave him a sample from the WGN drinking fountain. It's in the tubes marked with an S. Dr. Lux and his team ran their test. The control tubes contained antibiotics and zinc, which lit up, but not the WGN water. No contaminants, no fluorescence, clean.
So it's really just a matter of adding water to the tubes, mixing, waiting a little bit, and then visualizing with this illuminator.
Dr. Lux and his team 3D printed the illuminator in the lab at a cost of about $6.
The big vision is that this is an early step in trying to put power in people's hands to monitor their own environments, to protect their own health, and hopefully protect the health of, you know, the environment around them.
Right now, the team is working on detecting SARS-CoV-2 particles in the lab using their water test fundamentals. The hope is to ultimately make COVID-19 testing faster and more widely available. Back to you.